I will welcome the Philbin Rollup and Associates Public Finance Conversations for 2021. We have a little bit different format than we did in 2020. In 2021, we're focused more on questions or topics rather than an individual's career. In this case, Betsy Kiehn's career would be very interesting to follow, but we did change the format this year. Before I dive into Ms. Kiehn's resume, I want to talk a bit about how we first started working together. In California, during difficult budget times, or at least the last two difficult budget times, what the state has done is deferred school districts' revenue from one year to the next. That helps them balance their budget, but then often leaves the school districts in a situation where they're doing borrowings from one fiscal year to the next fiscal year. So you have a tough credit situation, you have a tough legal situation to work through, and you have a tough market situation. And one of those deals is how Betsy and I started working together. And I think, Betsy, that's a deal that we'll never forget. Is that right?
That's exactly right. It's so funny that you bring that up, because I was thinking about that very same time of how we started working together and really what a success that was and how many successes we've had together since then. So that's right.
Well, Betsy is the head of municipal capital markets at Stifel. She oversees and coordinates municipal institutional sales, trading and underwriting, and then she also actually works on individual transactions as well. So she's really understands what's going on with individual deals while also doing a lot of the management there as well. Her and her team do 200 new issues a year, all different types of credits, variable rate, fixed rate. Ms. Kiehn joined Stifel in 2004. At that time, it was Stone and Youngberg, and we all had several names for it, Stoney, SNY, whatever it was, but it was Stone and Youngberg, who was acquired by Stifel in 2001. And she holds a Bachelor of Science degree from the University of Vermont. Betsy, anything you would want to add to that?
No, I think you covered it. Thanks, Adam. It's really nice to be here today.
Great. Well, thank you. So for our first installment, our question is, I would like to talk a bit about what happened in 2020. While the news cycle is still fresh and got maybe even more exciting than it was in 2020, it's both 2020 is both an unforgettable year and there's a lot going on in the market. Can you tell us a bit about the municipal market and 2020?
Sure, I'd love to. You know, there was so much that happened in 2020 between the global pandemic, the election cycle, unprecedented volatility, and really finally and surprisingly, record low yields. So it was not a year that was short on event risk and making our way through really what was a challenging market. The volatility really took hold and played out in the spring as the onset of COVID-19 and the potential municipal implications led to quick and really record outflows overall, which in turn led to higher yields. As we saw the largest one-day adjustments, both higher in yield and lower in yield within the municipal market, and really what overnight seemed like our market was turning into a credit market away from a rate market, as which it had been for quite some time. I would say what was most impressive about those spring and summer months was how quickly we turned that all around, ultimately. You know, I think the resiliency of the market is something that a lot of people continue to talk about here as we start 2021, aided by certainly stimulus out of DC and the Fed. The municipal liquidity facility was pretty important. While not widely used, I think the perception overall that it was there was pretty critical to kind of getting everybody back up on their feet again. And we saw our market return to normalcy really halfway through the year. The calendar picked up, fund flows resumed to being positive, and that was helpful to the overall strength. I think even more than that, though, is as we, no one would have guessed in March, right, that we would have had a record year of issuance. $474 billion besting the 2017 record of $448 billion. But I think what was helpful to the market overall and the efficiency of that distribution was really the split between taxable and tax-exempt issuance. About a third of the market came as new issues came as taxable. And you've talked about previously, you know, the tax reform in 2017 and our inability to advance refund bonds. So the taxable market there became a helpful tool. But I think bigger than that was getting the market back onto its feet and really working to incorporate additional investors, right? Not this traditional tax-exempt municipal buyers, we were reaching to traditionally taxable buyers. And so I think that was helpful for two reasons, in that as we were making our way through $8 and $10 billion weeks and in some instances, $20 billion weeks, it was the diversity of that was pretty helpful. And I think long-term as well, from an issuer perspective, is diversity of ownership overall, as the challenge in March was really a challenge of liquidity, in that concentration of ownership led to those record outflows. And so, you know, we saw that issuance pick up. We saw a record month in October. And, you know, as issuers are trying to get into the market ahead of what was, many were expecting unprecedented volatility or learning to expect the unexpected, given the challenges of the spring, we saw record issuance in October and then a pretty orderly market as we made our way towards the end of the year, right? We saw 20 days of our benchmark yield curve, MMD, with little or no changes. And then I think the event risk of the election, you know, was one where the hesitation heading into that was met pretty well by dealers and investors alike. We saw dealer inventories really light ahead of that, but we continued to see the technicals perform well, which was money coming into the municipal market, while record outflows in March of $45 billion. Ultimately, at the end of the year, equaled $20 billion overall continuing to come into municipals. So a roller coaster of a year, lots of things certainly taking place. But overall, I think the performance of the municipal market is one that was pretty strong and surprisingly so.
Great. Thank you, Betsy. And that wraps up our first segment. And we'll see all of you next Wednesday when we get to our second question.